Welcome back to my reading corner. Today I'm going to review The Once and Future King by T.H. White. This is a retelling of the Arthurian legend of Arthur and the Round Table and Lancelot and all of those stories that a lot of people are already familiar with. And I really enjoyed this book. I think it took me about a month to read the entire thing. It's pretty long. My overall thoughts are that I really enjoyed it and that I would recommend it to anyone who is a fantasy lover. You meet Arthur when he is a child named Wart, and you follow him through the childhood development and the adventures with Merlin to him becoming king and all of the tragedies that ensue then. I don't know what else to call them, but you follow his entire life, basically. It's a really fun story. I would say that it's not necessarily fast-paced. It's a little bit older, and the writing style can sometimes meander a little bit, but it is also pretty engaging. If you like stories that are very character-driven, I think that you would enjoy this, because I think that the author does a really good job analyzing and developing the different personalities and the backstories of all of the characters, such as Arthur. Lancelot is very well developed. Guinevere, you get to see behind those popular characters that a lot of people are already familiar with. And that is probably the thing that I like the most about this book, is how well the characters were fleshed out. I know that T.H. White got most of his inspiration from Sir Thomas Malory, who wrote Les Mortes d'Arthur, and he's pulling from a lot of that telling of Arthur when he is writing this book. I really enjoyed reading it. I probably liked the first story, The Sword in the Stone, and the last story, The Candle in the Wind, the best. I'm not sure why exactly. I think those two, you got to see a lot of Arthur in them. With the two stories in the middle, you get to see Lancelot very well developed, which I guess I just felt less engaged in that story. And then the other one, you get to see the Orkney brothers, like Agravain, Gawain. There's a pair of another two, and their names sound very similar. And Mordred. So I just liked seen Arthur the best. I think he was just my favorite character. So that's probably why I like those two parts the best. Also, you get to meet Merlin, who I really liked reading about. Merlin is a very fun character. He totally reminds me of the Doctor from Doctor Who, Dumbledore, and also Gandalf. He's kind of a combination of all three, and it's fun to see his dialogue with Arthur. This book, I was surprised that there were actually some humorous parts in it. That was kind of interesting for me because I was expecting it to be a more dense read, but it definitely is broken up with little pieces of humor. I think when I got to the end of it, it was so strange to be wrapping up a book that I had read for so long. That's the kind of experience you get when you read a longer book, because you're with the characters for such a long time that it's more emotional, I think, when you get to the end and you're finally reading those last pages. But I think it makes the reading more satisfying in a way. So yeah, if you like Arthur and tellings of Arthur, like I know part of the reason I wanted to pick this book up is because I loved the TV show Merlin on BBC. And that is a completely different retelling. There are a lot of things that happen in that TV show that are very different than other stories that you see. I think this telling is more similar to what you would typically see. It's more similar to the source material. But it was still really fun to read, and I enjoyed it. I gave this book 5 stars on Goodreads, and it's definitely become a new favorite for me, just because I liked T.H.'s writing and how T.H. I enjoyed T.H. White's writing style and how he developed different themes and he thought about different things within the book itself. And I also liked how he developed the characters. And I think that was my favorite aspect of the book. So, overall, I love the book. I think that a lot of other people would as well. And if you have read this book or have heard about it before, comment down below so I can hear what you think. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!